move forward. When they are casting insult, move forward. When they are trying to blackmail you, move forward. For God is about to show them something. Oh, hallelujah. I said, God is about to show them something. Praise the Lord. And the Bible said they come between the Red Sea. And again, they started talking. Mama, stop talking and keep prayer. Stop talking and keep praying. Hallelujah. Because the word of God has spoken already. So when the word of God is being spoken, there is angelic power that will make sure that the word of God must come to pass. He said, I'm not a man to lie. So nothing can stop when God speaks. Nobody can stop the prophetic word of Jehovah.
Amen.
Amen. So the Bible said, they still went back and said, Moses, how can we go? Because there's a Red Sea. And the enemies are coming with full speed. What shall we do? And Moses went to God. So he said, go to God.
Go to God.
These people, how they can pray, that you pray for them always. Oh, amen.
Amen.
Teach people how they can fast, that you fasting for them.
Amen.
Teach people how they can wait upon the Lord. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Because two is always better than one.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, the Bible said, Moses went to God and prayed, and God said, tell them to move forward.
Amen.
And he said, stretch forth your rod onto the sea. God is telling Moses to approach the problems. Don't run from the issue. Approach it. The first step to defeat your enemy is to approach them.
That's it.
Hallelujah. Once you approach anything, the thing becomes afraid. Hallelujah. Before a tiger will come after you, a tiger will first approach and see your reaction. So if you react that you are afraid, then you forcefully and speed come against you, because you have signaled to the tiger that you are afraid of him. So the tiger has seen that, hey, this place is afraid. But when the tiger will run, you also do like this.
Yes.
The tiger will go back.
Yes.
Dog never chase anybody that is standing. Unless you run, God bless you.
Yes.
God will never chase it. The dog will never chase anybody that is standing.
Once
you run, you stand, he will just also come. He want you to run so that you take advantage and bite your feet. Someone said, I will not run. So never run from any issue. Face the issue. Someone said,
I will not run.
The devil will try for you to run so that he pursue you and destroy your life. Someone said,
I will not run.
He said, stretch forth the rod. And because in the beginning, I taught you something with the rod. Use what God has taught you and apply them and to break you too. Because God has taught me how to pray. He has taught me how to humble. He has taught me how to wait before him. He has taught me how to go through afflictions and all predicament. He has taught me.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I like God to teach you things.
Amen.
Because the best teacher is life.
Amen.
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 So when Moses swept off the rod, the Bible says, and the Red Sea divided, parted into two. Mama, anytime you approach a problem, the problem will pray through for you.
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Every time you step in to face and challenge anything, that thing is already defeated.
Yeah.
Are you catching the revelation?
Yeah.
Goliath was threatening David to put fear. David also was approaching Goliath with the word of God. He said, I come against you. In the name of Almighty God, the God of Israel, whom you have defied. So Goliath became disturbed and said, how can this little boy with all my stature and all my ammunition, why is he still confronting me? So as I'll confront them. We are going to confront the gates of our enemies and take our possession. Oh, hallelujah. So as I confront it. Don't run from any trouble. There's a word that he would not run from a fight will live to fight another day. So start and finish the fight. I said, stand and do what? Finish the fight. If you run from a battle, there's another battle waiting for you. But once you defeat your enemy in the battle, no, everybody's afraid of you. Because if somebody hear that you have been beaten, they think that they can also beat you. Because somebody beat you last week. So everybody wants to come and beat you.
Yes.
But once they hear that you beat somebody yesterday, once they hear it, they are afraid of you. Because they know you might also beat them. I declare by the power of God, with anointing that you have, no enemy can stand before you. In the mighty name of Jesus. For the Bible says, I have seen my sacred oil upon my servant David, who have anointed, and I will beat down his enemy in the presence of him, and I will exalt his horn at the horn of Gideon. Somebody shout, I hear you. Your enemies.
Amen.
So was our confront.
Amen.
So when the Red Sea parted, they were walking through. Someone said walking through. Amen. Only both people who walk through any trials.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Any people that are strong,
yes,
they are the people that can walk through any circumstances.
Mm.
Because the fearful people will always run back.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Never move with a fearful person.
Yes.
Because when the heat comes, the person ran from you. Some people, when they say, let's go and fight that person, while they go and they see the body of the person, they will run and leave you alone. And they will beat you until you die. So move with bold people. Move with people that can encourage you. Move with people that can encourage you and say, we can do it in the name of Jesus. Paul said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Oh, hallelujah. Fear people will always say negative things. Don't you see that you can't do it? Don't you see that you are not making it? Don't you see that it's about time that you quit?
Yes, that's it.
Amen. Don't you see that it's about time that this and that? Because they are afraid. They said, oh, Moses, we've seen the land. It's good, but they are enemies. There are some people that are giants. They call them the Anakites. They are half human and